Good morning, Dominic. Today is Thursday, May 7th. So we are right here on the calendar, May 7th. Okay. All right, get your book out. I need an eraser. Read with me. I'm going to send you an assignment that tells you how to read your story to me. I want you to use the microphone, or you can video yourself. That's fine too. I just want to hear you reading your story. I made a mistake. I need an eraser. I need an eraser. This eraser is no good. I made a mistake. I need an eraser. Look in your pencil box. You might find one there. I still need an eraser. This eraser is no good. So he didn't find one in his pencil box, did he? Look in my pencil drawer. You might find one there. I found an eraser. I fixed my mistake. I made a mistake. I need some tape. Oops. All right, Dominic, I want you to read this to mom and dad, okay, two or three more times, and then you're going to videotape yourself or use the microphone so I can hear you read your book, okay? I want to hear you. All right, we're going to work on our last page of our packet. All right, number one, where did this story take place? So think about where he was. Is it A, school, B, home, C, car? B, it happened at home, right? He was at home, like you. Number two, why did the boy need an eraser? A, he lost his eraser. B, his eraser was stolen, or C, he made a mistake. Why would he need an eraser? Good job. C, he made a mistake. Number three, what is a mistake? A, a new toy. B, something wrong. Or C, a thing to write with. What is a mistake? B, something wrong. Number four, where did the boy look first? Now, where did he look first? A, desk, B, drawer, or C, pencil box? Where did he look first? C, pencil box. Good job, Dominic. Number five, what else did the boy need? A, tape, B, pencil, or C, crayons? What else did he need? Good job, A, tape. Now, let's look at number six. Have the student write a sentence explaining what the boy did at the end of the story. So I want you to tell mom or dad, what did the boy do at the end of the story? So think about the end of the story. Okay? All right. We can put that to the side. Now let's look at our sight words. Here are our new sight words. Say them with me. Your, need, made, good, look, I, mistake. All right, I'm going to point to them and I want you to say them before I do. Made, your, look, good, I, need, tough one. Mistake. Good job, Dominic. Okay. Now you're going to need a piece of paper, and I want you to number 1 to 10, you're going to take your spelling test. So number 1 to 10, if you need to pause the video to do that, go ahead and pause the video. Okay. Number 1. My brother lives in Sunbury. My. Number 2. Made. We made dinner last night. Made. Number three, no. The teacher said no, no. Number five, box. I received a box in the mail, box. Number five, I am teaching from home, I. Number six, there. I put the book over there, there. Number seven, still. She still needs to go for a walk, still. Number eight, fix. Can you fix my broken pencil sharpener? Fix. Number nine, tape. The boy needed tape at the end of the story. Tape. Number 10, need. You need ketchup for your hamburger. Need. Okay, I need a picture of your spelling test. And let's open our handwriting books to page 48. Page 48. While you're doing that, I'm going to get my board here ready. All right, so today we're going to practice capital V and lowercase v. Okay, so capital V starts a little bit below the top line. It curves up and touches the top line, comes down to the bottom line, curves, back up to the top line, and curves again. Kind of like the start of a U. Capital U does the same exact thing and comes up, but then it comes straight down. The capital V stays at the top and makes a little bit of a curve up there. Okay, watch again. Curve, comes down, curve, goes back up, and curves. Capital V. Lowercase v has a hump, then comes down, curves to the middle line, and then it has a point and a tail. So watch again. Hump, curve, point, tail. All right. Then we have the word very. So V, point, tail. Right from your tail, you're going to make it extra long so you can make your E, R, and then Y. Hump up to the middle line, then straight back down and give him his curve. All right. Now let's go to even. E, V, hump, down, point, tail. Make your tail extra long. Then E, N. And the last one, world. W, okay, point, tail, just like the V. Then O, R, L, D. That's a tough one. Okay, so practice that one. And then day four. Now, this is the first day four that you've had this year in my class. So what you have to do is go to the back of the book and you will see these picture pages. Okay, pick a picture page. Doesn't matter. I don't care which one. And you're going to copy this sentence. Okay, the scripture. It's actually a scripture. It says, long ago, comma, even before he made the world, comma, God chose us to be his very own, period. And that comes from Ephesians chapter 1, verse 4. So all you do is copy that onto this page back here. And then if you have some crayons, you can color your page. Okay, so I need a picture of page 48. Okay, and then don't forget to send me a picture of your day four as well. Okay, all right, so that's that. Let's work on phonics, okay? Turn to page 113. We're going to do the short O sound, like ah, say ah, octopus, like octopus. All right, on page 113, it says, my dog has lots of spots. My dog's spots look like dots. My dog's spots are on his hair. My dog's spots are everywhere. A very cute Dalmatian. puppy. Spot has the short sound of O. Circle each picture whose name has the short sound of O. So we're looking for ah. Okay, number one, top. Yep, circle it. Number two, pop. Yep, circle it. Number three, cup. Do you hear ah? Nope. How about lock? Do you hear ah? Yep, circle it. How about number five, sock? Do you hear ah? Yeah, circle it. How about tack? Do you hear ah? Nope. How about box? Do you hear ah? Yep. Pot? Do you hear ah? Yep. How about rock? Do you hear ah? Yep. Knot? Do you hear ah? Yep. And we have a mop. Do you hear ah? Yeah, very good. And how about mitt? Do you hear ah? No. Good job, Dominic. All right, so the ah sound. All right, turn to page 114. Page 114. So here we have to say the names of the pictures in each row. Color the pictures whose names rhyme. All right, are you ready? We have a cow, axe, box, fox. Which one? Okay, there we go. Which ones rhyme? Good, box and fox. So circle them. You can color them later. Number two, we have mitt, pot, not, cat. Which ones rhyme? Good, pot and not. So circle pot and not. Number three, we have pop, we have top, we have cup, and we have mop. Ooh, I see more than two, do you? Yeah, pop, top, and mop all rhyme. So circle all of them, all three of them. Don't circle cup. Number four, we have dog, tag, log, and frog. Which ones rhyme? Ooh, this one's a tricky one too. I found three, did you? Dog, log, and frog. Good job, circle them. All right, number five, we see a sock, a duck, a rock, and a lock. Which ones rhyme? Good, three again, right? Sock, rock, and lock. Circle them. Good job, Dominic. All right, page 115. Okay, say the name of each picture, circle its name. So we have to listen to the sound so we circle the right word. So we have a pot. Which one of these says pot? Good, this the middle one, P-O-T, circle pot. This one is a fox. Which one of these three words says fox? Good, the middle one, F-O-X, fox. Then we have a log. Which one of these says log? Good, the first one, L-O-G, log. Okay, number four, we have a picture of a mop. Which one of these three words says mop? Good, the last one, M-O-P, mop, circle mop. Next picture is a top. Which one says top? Good, the last one, T-O-P, top. Okay, this one is hot. That guy is hot. Which one says hot? Good, the middle one, H-O-T, hot. Down to number seven, we have a dog. Which one says dog? The first one, good, D-O-G, dog. Then we have a box. Which one says box? The middle one, good. B-O-X, box. The next one is a doll. Listen to the sounds. Doll. Good. The last one, D-O-L-L. Then we have an ox. Which one spells ox? Good. The first one, O-X, ox. We have a rock. Which one spells rock? Would be the last one, R-O-C-K. And the last number, number 12, pop. Which one spells pop? The first one, P-O-P. Okay, Dominic. All right, now on the next page, this is the one you're going to send me a picture of, okay? So here's what it looks like. It's page 116. It says, color each short O word red. What do you see? So I need a short O sound, that ah sound. Okay, so you have to find the ah word. So read those words. You should be able to read those words. They, some of them have the short A sound, the short E sound, the short I sound, the short U sound. We've talked about every single one of those letters. Okay, find the ah sounds. Then use some of the short O words in the puzzle to write a sentence. So write me a sentence with one or two of those ah words in there, okay? So color the ah, short ah words red. Nothing else gets colored, just the short O words, okay? All right, let's recap. So I don't need a picture of that. I need you to send me a picture of your handwriting, page 48. I need a picture of phonics, page 116. And I need your spelling test. Okay, so three pictures today. That also need a video or a recording with the microphone of you reading I Need an Eraser. Okay? All right, Dominic, have a great day. Bye.